We started off with this by taking his poem, The Raven, right, and finding an image. You can actually get this image on the Hallmark website or on my website.
Look at this.
And we did this amazing glow-in-the-dark mirror.
Oh, sorry.
Which really,
I love this effect. Love this effect.
Can't get easier. We have a tape here of me making this earlier this morning. Super easy.
So I learned how to do that. Let's do it.
Did you? What I did was I started with the image, traced it onto contact paper, just good old contact paper, cut it out with scissors. You could do this with any shape. I like the raven, but any shape. You could even do it with initials. Once you have it, peel off the sticky backing, the lovely mirror. I love this music.
Yeah.
Right.
That's like a Snow White mirror, like mirror, mirror on the wall. Okay, so you just put it on the mirror itself?
Make sure you get it nice and flat, get the bubbles out, and then tape off the edge of the mirror so your spray paint doesn't bleed.
Oh, what? Oh.
And then you can buy glow-in-the-dark spray paint.
Oh.
And just
glow-in-the-dark.
Yes, you heard it here. Glow-in-the-dark spray paint.
Oh, can you spray paint your children?
Oh, could be good.
Child services, child services. He's kidding.
And then let it dry, and then you just peel off.
That's so cool.
And you're done. So it looks great in the daytime, but then turn out the lights and
oh my gosh, I'm so doing this. Okay, I gotta give you props. Right there, come on. Props. That is fantastic.
It's easy, cheap, and really fun. You use a secondhand mirror. You can do them in little picture frames around the house. The lights go out. Really magical.
I love
that. But that spray will work on anything?
Anything. Not your children.
Not your children.
No, he's going to put up an 8x10 glossy of himself.
So we can see it at night.
Yeah, right.
And my blouse.
Your blouse. Okay.
So to go along with this, we have three things that you can get on Hallmark.com or on KennethWingard.com. We have the actual poem itself, the raven, and a branch. So what you can do is you can just go to the website and print these out on vellum. Vellum is sort of a translucent paper that you see here, and we're gonna make lanterns out of them.
Oh, okay.
So what I've done is I printed each of these out, I cut them down to size, and I just have three. You could use drinking glasses, you could use small vases, and all you're gonna do is wrap the vellum around and tag it with a small piece of
Scotch tape.
Scotch tape, and you're done.
Oh,
you put a votive on the inside of that.
I thought we were going to get complicated, have to spray these or something with like glue or.
And what's great about this is that when you're done with the holidays, you take off the tape and you are
done.
You know, you're finished.
You can do this throughout all the holidays.
All the holidays.
The guys did it.
We're tape specialists.
Yeah, I need another tape. Yeah, there we go.
Look at that.
Yeah.
And the candle goes in.
Candle goes in.
Well,
you get a nice
flicker. We have this over here.
And you can do them in a big jumbo size.
Look at this.
So now we've got other elements here. We're going to bring them over and actually get the table going.
Okay.
I always like to start with some muslin because that just sort of softens the edges of your tables. You can either, you can buy this at Halloween stores. You can also just get your cooking kind and dip it in a little black dye, or they would be like totally tie-dyeing this.
Ken, what is this obscure thing? I've never seen anything quite like this.
This
before.
Is the beginning of the tablet.
Oh, okay.
So you have a vintage typewriter. I took another piece of the vellum, roll that in. It's a great look. Why don't you go and put that right there?
May I ask
center.
A question? This is heavy. Is this a real pumpkin you sprayed silver?
Yes.
Because that's super heavy.
Real pumpkin, a can of silver spray paint.
It's genius.
And
I
all
love
of a sudden, it
it
looks like the, you know, the expensive glass ones that you buy.
It does. It looks like mercury glass. This
is, super, super
that.
Easy. And then old books. I think old books are a really, really great, not quite spooky, but they add a certain
also an
it.
Early element of the tablet.
Yes, exactly. Right. Pre-tablet.
Pre-tablet.
No, you stack these. I use old books all the time. You can get them for little of nothing.
I know you want those.
But and then, let's see here. Why don't you put some books right there on that corner?
You're switching?
We're
going to
put
I think
okay.
all the books are down.
All right.
Low, do you want? Oh, I see. There's some underneath. Oh, my goodness. You come
and we can hang a lantern. Why don't we?
Look at this.
Want to pop those right here, Christina?
Sure.
They don't make books like this anymore.
Oh, old lanterns.
This is fun. Look, we're doing it as a family. Isn't this nice?
Which is what really decorating is about. It brings families together. It's not about, you know, don't do it when the kids are at school. It should be a family affair.
It's a family affair, right. And look, here are the candles that Tanya made yesterday.
I know, I love this
little
candle project.
Isn't that great?
Yeah, you pop that in. Oh, look, he's reading.
Well, that's a new concept for him.
Okay. Yeah, a new concept.
Wait, I want to take a look at it from over here.
Let's see from.
What do we think?
Oh, looks nice. I love it.
Easy, inexpensive. And then when you're done, you know, the books back on the bookshelf, you take the paper off the candles, and you've got your vases back.
It's good because using books, because they scare my kids.
Books
yeah,
scare
you. They're so afraid to read. It's like, read more. I got to read more. Thank
this
you.
This is great.
Ken.
Thank
very
you, Ken.
Great. And there's
fabulous.
Lots of great. We have a new season of Homemade Simple starting, so please check that out.
Great.
Lots of great ideas like this.
Okay.
Good eats.